It's 6:40 though, let's get a check of our weather. A lot of kids are gonna be heading out to the bus stop maybe in the next 20 minutes or so, and they really wanna bundle up because it is cold out there.
That's right, the coldest air we've seen so far this season right now in central Georgia with temperatures in the teens, but then wind chills in the single digits for many outside. Looking live over downtown, again at 18 right now in Macon with this breeze out of the west northwest at 8 though, it makes it feel like 8 degrees outside. We're headed to 44 with plenty of sun later today, but that wind chill going to consistently stay below the actual air temperatures through the day on this Wednesday. 14 in Atlanta, 15 in Athens, 18 over in Columbus, as well as here in Macon. We drove this back down into central Georgia. You find 15 over there in Monticello, 16 in Forsyth, 17 in Roberta. So a lot of teens, 20s elsewhere across parts of south of the fall line, 21 in McRae, 21 in Swainsboro, and 27 over in Vidalia. But here are the feels like temperatures again, 8 in Macon, 6 in Roberta, 9 in Butler and Montezuma, 11 is what it feels like right now in Americus, 15 in McRae and 21 over in Swainsboro, and the sun still just about an hour away from coming up. So it's going to stick like this for a while. You compare these temperatures compared to where we were this time yesterday, 33 degrees colder in Macon, 34 degrees colder in Warner Robins, 32 in Marshallville and 33 degrees colder in Unadilla. So cold no matter how you slice it. Send me your current temperature where you are. You can head over to my Facebook page. There's a post there right now where you can leave that there in the comments. We've got a list going on 13WMAZ.com. You can also send it there on X or Instagram. So the radar picture, quiet. We're happy about that one because if it wasn't quiet, we would be talking about straight up snow outside, and that's not going to be a possibility with high pressure back into Mississippi. Once we get this high pressure on the east side of us, we'll get the southerly flow in, and that will warm our temperatures a little closer to where we should be for this time of year by the time we get to tomorrow afternoon. But for this morning, temperatures in the 20s feeling like the teens. By the time we get to the noon hour, mixing in some more 30s, but still feeling like the 20s. And then later this afternoon, I actually expect to get to about 44 in Macon, but still feeling like the 30s. Outside on into the overnight hours and into tomorrow morning, looking at temperatures still cold down near 20 once again, but then rebounding into the 50s by the time we get to the afternoon. Some increasing clouds into the night with some passing showers. Most of us will be asleep, so we're not really going to see the showers, but you might wake up to a wet car by the time you get to Friday morning. And then once we get into Friday afternoon, temperatures beginning to fall once again as another Arctic blast moves into central Georgia. So another one of those upside down days where we'll be warmer in the morning and then cooler at night. 39 for Saturday, 45 on Sunday. Hello, Arctic blast 2.0. Overnight low temperatures down into the teens, but I'm not expecting the wind chills to be quite as bad for the weekend as they are this morning across central Georgia. Here's your 7-day forecast. 44 today, 51 tomorrow, 50 for Friday. So there's that warm up. And we get into the weekend with that next Arctic blast on into next week. Highs a little closer to where they should be for this time of year. And just looking beyond Tuesday, I do think we'll keep that warming trend going. In fact, closer to 70, yes, 70 degrees by the time we get to Friday.